Yeah, so Great Raft is a craft brewery in Shreveport, but kind of a selfish endeavor for Lindsay and I, because we really wanted a great, kind of a world-class craft brewery to represent our hometown of Shreveport.
South is like the last frontier for craft beer. We're a few years behind everywhere else in the country. Whenever we moved to DC after college, we were introduced to a world of craft beer that we didn't really know existed.
And I was just like, man, I'm so tired of coming home and not having good beer options. We could totally pull this off. And she got kind of tired of me saying that, because I've been saying that for months, you know. And I remember she handed me a legal pad, said, you know, start writing down ideas, start forming a business plan.
We're the 9th brewery in the state of Louisiana and the first brewery in Shreveport since Prohibition. We knew coming to Shreveport, where less than 2% of the market is drinking craft beer, that we couldn't come here and survive just on brewing sour, funky beers. I feel like sometimes people think that, you know, craft beer drinkers are pretentious. It has to be the hoppiest this or the rarest that or the barrel-aged everything. And, you know, we just want to make an approachable, enjoyable beer.
These styles are the hardest to get right. They're not intense, they're delicate, there's nothing to hide behind. So if we screw those beers up, we've got to dump it, because our customers will call us out on that. So when we started thinking about what we want in terms of styles, we knew we wanted to have an approachable beer. Our seasonal lineup is kind of a balance, right? Because we've got to support the flagships, we've got to keep them fresh on the shelf, and anywhere from Arkansas to East Texas to New Orleans, that's our main focus. Those are year-round beers. But when we have the capacity, we like to play around with some of our seasonal beers.
I think a lot of people's palates are starting to evolve. We know we're 3 years into this thing, so a lot of Southern draw drinkers have evolved into commotion drinkers, and some of the people who started as commotion drinkers are Grace and Grit drinkers.
Or some people say they don't like beer. To me, that's they haven't had the right beer yet. And it's a broad range of different flavor profiles out there.
We knew from the very beginning that we wanted to have a tasting room. That was one thing that breweries in Louisiana weren't really taking advantage of.
Tasting room has always been a huge educational piece. It's people coming here interested about this and that, and it's very easy to answer questions by saying, hey, let's walk out to the floor and I'll show you exactly how we package our beer and exactly what tank this came from and exactly where our barrels are at.
Yeah, so a lot of people on our tour will ask us, well, so, you know, I see these stacks of cans behind you. Why do you can versus bottle? It seems like every brewery bottles. And the biggest thing for us is the quality.
The best way to make a bad beer is to brew a great beer and package it poorly. That's, you know, our can line will do 40 cans a minute. That's 40 mistakes a minute if it's not dialed in, purging it with CO2, making it a perfect vessel for can, getting that seam on perfectly, getting that date code so consumers know when the beer was canned by. It's a big system of all these quality checks that we put in line, because it's important. And sometimes it doesn't work out. Sometimes we have controllers that break. The beer gets too warm and doesn't taste well. And sometimes we dump a tank. But we make it as a team, and we know that that's not the best beer we can put out, so it goes down the drain. And I don't think any of us lose any sleep. We hear all the time, it's like, oh, it's really good beer for Shreveport, or it's a really good restaurant for Shreveport. I hate that last part for Shreveport. We want to be a great beer, period, and have the high standards. And we've built that quality into our program since day one.
So whenever we first started brewing, we bought our initial brew house and fermentation vessels. And we realized within about the first quarter that Shreveport was thirstier than we thought they were. And we immediately started the process of purchasing new tanks. And over time have grown our cellar to where it is today, which is about 10 to 12,000 barrels of capacity. Yeah, you're never gonna get Great Raft in all 50 states. We wanna support Louisiana first, and also, as the market demands it, like you said, you know, share our beer with as many people as possible within the South.
We have a saying that we make equal investments in our capacity and our volume to get beer out the door as quality. So it's kind of a mindset that we're not only making more beer, but better beer. So we've added a few things to our lab. We've added a centrifuge that helps us separate our beer and package it better. And ultimately, we're just trying to put the best product on the shelf and grow our quality at the same time as our capacity.
We could have started a brewery anywhere. We felt very compelled to start a brewery in our hometown, where there was a great need for one. We can't survive here without the support of the local community. So we're here to make Shreveport a better place.
If we're not involved, we're just a brewery in the middle of a town that has no tie to the local area. It's super important for us when we started to have the brewery, the brand, the tasting room to be ingrained in our community. And that means, like you said, partnering with nonprofits, the Humane Society around the corner, we do all kinds of stuff with. It's very cool when you see these three-day-old beers in the market and you see your friends and family drinking it, and they don't drink it because it's local, they drink it because it's good. It's awesome to see the Serotones at their European send-off in August drinking a four-day-old commotion. So that's our that's our commitment. That's what we've got to do. We've got to make it a Shreveport brand that people are proud of and drink it, not because it's local, because it's damn good beer.